opposed to my cousin.
Hey, are you planning on marrying your sibling? Or having children with your cousin? Well,
don't even think about it.
We wouldn't recommend it.
Well, why not?
Whether your dad is also your uncle or your grandma is your aunt, inbreeding can be confusing. In medieval times, it was quite common, but it had disastrous consequences.
Well, I didn't know she was my sister when I kissed her.
Why does inbreeding lead to health complications in babies? What would your inbred child look like? This is Your Body On Inbreeding. Inbreeding happens when two genetically similar organisms mate. Since we already share 99.9% of our DNA with every other human on Earth, one of the biological purposes of mating is the shuffling of that 0.1% of DNA. The similarity in genetics might be the result of the Toba eruption that took place 75,000 years ago in Indonesia. The volcanic eruption affected the environment and almost got humans wiped out from the Earth. It's estimated that the eruption left the planet with only 1 to 10,000 breeding pairs of humans. So, could you be a result of inbreeding without even knowing? Is that why these celebrities look so much alike? Well, it's a little more complicated. There's a reason why inbreeding goes against social norms in human society, but this wasn't always the case. Prince Charles II of Spain was born in 1661 to King Philip IV of Spain and Mariana of Austria. They were uncle and niece. The family's wishes to maintain the bloodline resulted in a prince who was unable to speak until he was 4 years old and couldn't walk until the age of 8. He had a pronounced underbite and an engorged tongue that prevented him from closing his teeth together. And mentally, he had troubles too. He suffered from hallucinations. So, what caused all of these defects? Well, it boils down to genetics. Humans have two sets of 23 stretches of DNA called chromosomes. We get one set from mom and one from dad. In each of these chromosomes, there are thousands of genes that determine physical and biological features. Genes can be dominant or recessive. When one of the genes is dominant, the baby will get the trait from that gene. But if both the genes are recessive, it will originate a recessive gene. This is known as an autosomal recessive gene. When two copies of an abnormal gene are passed on to offspring, it can lead to congenital disabilities and genetic diseases. This phenomenon happens when there's a limited gene pool in a species. Inbreeding limits the gene pool and, by doing so, reduces the number of available healthy mates. This can eventually cause a population decrease. Just ask Neanderthals. Yeah, they tell you that this isn't a good idea. Wait, right, they can't tell you that because they're extinct. And they're extinct because... yeah, you guessed it, because they inbred. Neanderthals lived in smaller populations, so it makes sense that they mated with their close relatives. This theory was proposed based on the analyzed genome sequence of a Neanderthal woman. The results showed that her parents were half-siblings. Homozygosity is possessing two identical traits of a gene. This is determined by the relationship between your parents.
Well, you two make a cute couple.
For instance, if your parents were siblings, they'd have many genes in common. And I'm not just talking about denim pants.
Oh, you're my sister!
If the parents both carry the same genetic mutation, the child is at a higher risk of an autosomal recessive disease like sickle cell disease or cystic fibrosis. Monozygotic twins share 100% of their genes. A parent and child share 50%. You share a quarter of your genes with your aunt and only an eighth with your cousins. Without a history of autosomal recessive conditions in the family, first cousins have more than a 90% chance of having a perfectly healthy baby. But that doesn't mean that you should fall in love with your first cousin and have babies. Even if the inbred children turn out to be healthy in the first generation, the long-term effects to offspring could be reduced fertility, reduced birth weight, higher infant and child mortality, reduced immune function, and facial asymmetry. Remember Charles II? Cognitive disabilities, reduced muscular function, and decreased lung function are other possible consequences of mating with your family.
You made out with your sister!
Now, if you're curious to learn more about genetics, well, have you ever wondered what it would be like to have octuplets? We'll find out on another episode of Your Body On.